The miraculous rescue of a three-year-old girl who had been buried for more than 2 days in the massive landslide in Maco, Davao de Oro. This brings the number of survivors in the tragedy to 31. The girl was rushed to the doctor's community hospital before she was transferred to the Davao Regional Medical Center in Tagum City. Officials say the girl is in stable condition and continues to regain her strength. Emergency responders are digging through thick mud in search for over 100 people who remain unaccounted for. 11 bodies have so far been recovered in the tragedy that occurred Tuesday, following days of incessant rains. Meanwhile, the Philippine Environment Department is not suspending Apex Mining's operations in the wake of the landslide in Maco, Davao de Oro. Environment Undersecretary Jocelyn Fragada tells Teleradio Servicio the landslide did not occur within Apex Mining's tenement. He adds Apex may continue their operations as they see fit. Fragada asserts the DENR will continue to monitor the situation in Davao de Oro.
In terms of determining whether they should operate because of the weather, or extreme weather condition, we leave it up to them. No? But we are continuing to support them and trying to communicate with them constantly. We have para makita rin po nila na we're aware of what's happening. Mm-hmm. So of course, I mean, if it's in the long run, we see na talagang alangan, we will recommend that as well.
Flood victims in Agusan del Sur appeal for more aid. More than 260,000 individuals are affected as most parts of the province remain submerged following heavy rains. Many families are now staying at evacuation centers.
Marami pa actually mga area na sinasabi nila na kailangan pa papuntahan dahil hindi nga sila napuntahan dahil ang daming mga parang isolated places na hindi talaga pa nabisita, hindi lang yung along the river, yung mga nasa bundok, no? So yun yung mga sinasabi na kailangang mamonitor kasi may mga landslide na nangyayari din doon. And we have actually to identify ano-ano pa yung mga damages ngayon.
Neighboring Agusan del Norte is also reeling from floods, particularly communities near the Agusan River. Displaced residents are also calling for government assistance. In other news, more Filipinos now supportive of the International Criminal Court probe into the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. A social weather station's poll made public Thursday suggested 53% of its 1,200 respondents approve of the investigation. This was 8 notches higher from the 45% in March. Some 57% also agreed that the Marcos administration should allow ICC probers into the country. But majority of them were still skeptical if foreign investigators would be able to conduct an impartial probe. The SWS survey ran from December 8 to 11. Rights groups estimate that thousands were summarily executed in the anti-narcotics operations. President Marcos reiterated last month the government will not help the ICC in its probe. But he also said investigators will not be barred entry to the country to gather evidence on the killings. The Makabayan Bloc in Congress has welcomed the SWS findings. One of its members, Congresswoman Arlene Brosas, believes more Filipinos are now convinced that those behind the killings should be held accountable. Congresswoman Franz Castro, meanwhile, says they remain hopeful that the ICC probe will yield a good result.
Alam natin ay nag-iimbestiga pa rin ang ICC at kumukuha pa rin ng mga testimonya na related dito sa drug on war o dito sa crime against humanity, bunga ng war on drugs ni dating Presidente Duterte at ng kanyang administration on.
After Marcos's pronouncement, the People's Initiative on Charter Change is now dead on the water. That's according to Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri. Zubiri expressed confidence that Senator Sonny Angara would productively lead discussions on the proposed economic amendments. Angara welcomed Marcos's delimitation, saying it's a signal for the House to put political amendments on the back burner. Meanwhile, a House lawmaker says the president's endorsement should end the prolonged word war in Congress. Congressman Robert Barbers added the president's remarks assures the Senate there is no basis in its accusations against alleged House plans to abolish the upper chamber. The Philippine Fisheries Bureau successfully conducts a resupply mission to Filipino fisher folk in Rizal Reef. The BFAR team delivered food, fuel, and other provisions to 16 fishermen moored in the area. Officials say no Chinese vessels were observed during the mission. On previous occasions, around 30 Chinese vessels were monitored around the reef, which rests in the West Philippine Sea. A Philippine court orders the cancellation of the passport of expelled Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. The Justice Department said Friday it has received the order from the Manila Regional Trial Court. Teves is deemed by the government as a mastermind in the March 2023 killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. Teves has since denied these claims. The National Bureau of Investigation has been told to ensure Teves' safe return to the country. The erstwhile lawmaker has refused to fly home, citing threats to his life. He was expelled as a member of Congress in August for repeatedly ignoring orders to return to the country.